Good morning. Welcome to EduSet Network. Friend, as you know, today we are going to discuss marketing communication. The precise topic is integrated marketing communication. In the last lecture, we just tried to understand what is the marketing communication, its basic concept. We will move further and we'll try to understand the integrated marketing communication in detail. And for discussion on this very topic, we have in studio eminent person, Professor Ravi Shankar. He is senior academician. And he is known name in the field of management education, and in the last three decades of his teaching, he has served in various institutions like MDI Gurgaon, IGNO, IMC, Indian Institute of Mass Communication, and he is presently chairperson of the GSD division, IFT, Indian Institute of Foreign Trade, and he has written many books. The two books are very popular among the students of management, are Services Marketing and Managing Distribution. And Professor Ravi Shankar is also quite active in different institutions. He is a member of Academic Council and Board Association of different institutions and universities. And he is also visiting for faculty in the different universities of the world. Like he has been invited from the Germany, France, Vancouver. And he has also conducted training from the Commonwealth country. So he's a known name in the field of management education, has contributed a lot in the marketing management and this field. So I think his knowledge and experience will help us to understand this topic and will give insight how to understand, how to follow the marketing management, or you say the marketing communication, for the better performance of any organization. So on your behalf, I welcome him for the EduSet lecture on this very topic. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, and welcome to the participants this morning. The topic has been introduced yesterday, and what I'm going to do today is to expand on that further. There are two things which we combine. One is called marketing, other is communication. And let us first develop clarity on each of these two terms, and then put them together, so that we are very clear about the meaning of the concept called integrated marketing communication or marketing communication. Let us begin with an example. The example I would like to take of the family planning program. The government of India, maybe 5 decades ago, they started a program for family planning. They thought the population is growing at a rate which is higher than the rate at which it should really grow, and all the developmental efforts of the government, they get neutralized because the population of the country is increasing at a much faster rate than it should. And they thought of a communication program. In terms of communication, that program was highly, highly successful. But in terms of marketing communication, perhaps it was not successful. In terms of communication, yes, everybody knew what is the meaning of Parivar Niyojan, family planning. That was a program which later on became Parivar Kalyan, family welfare. You go to the interior most part of the country, you show the inverted red triangle, people would comprehend the program is for reducing the family size. But if you ask them whether they have gone for a smaller family, the answer was no. You could find that people had more children than 2 or 3. The campaign was actually, do ya teen bache hote hain ghar mein ache. The program really, really, in terms of communication, was a phenomenal success. In the really, in the remotest part of the country, and the remotest village of this country, and the last person in a village also knew them, has seen that, inverted red triangle. So in terms of communication, it was very successful. In terms of marketing communication, if I call it, it was not. And I picked up this example just to make the meaning very clear between, or the difference very clear between communication and marketing communication. Communication aims at understanding. That is the objective of communication. Understanding. Many a times when we talk to somebody, the other person says something to you and you say, oh, you didn't understand me, or you didn't follow me, or I didn't mean that way. When these expressions are heard, obviously the communication didn't take place because the other person didn't understand. So the communication means reaching a higher level of understanding. People understand, but then they don't act. Because motivating people to act is far more important, and also it requires far more greater stimuli to create that kind of a response. So I would put it in a very different way, and I'll call it that when you talk about sender, message, receiver as a communication model, that there is a sender has a message, and the message reaches a receiver. I'm sure these basics must have been discussed yesterday. I put it in a different way. I always say that R should not stand for receiver, but R should represent response. What response you want to generate? Now that when you look at response, then you are very clear that these are my objectives. You objectivize communication. You communicate with an objective. So therefore, be very clear about the response. And then develop stimuli. S stands for stimuli. The stimuli could be visual, verbal, vocal, graphics, animation, copy, anything. But a combination of that comes out as communication, which you transmit in mass media or any other form. So in my understanding, the first thing I would like to emphasize on that you, at your level, it's very important for you to start differentiating between what is communication, what is marketing communication. Marketing communication is always objectivized. There is always an objective. Now, family planning program was not objectivized. Actually, it was ad hoc. Subsequently, the campaign was changed, and then the slogan was Hum Do Hamare Do. There was a time they were saying Do Ya Teen Bacche Hote Hain Ghar Mein Acche. I remember I was in school in those times, and all the walls in our government buildings were painted with faces of man and a woman and a boy child and a girl child. And the slogan was Do Ya Teen Bacche. But later on, when I came in college, the program changed further, and it said Hum Do Hamare Do. Today the program stands for girl child. The program says Ladka Ho Ya Ladki. In the you might have seen that in the red semicircle they show a man and a woman and a girl child. This is nothing but an ad hoc policy. Ad hoc, you are not very sure what you want to communicate. Now you look at commercially for a brand. A brand like Old Spice, I'm not promoting any brand here, so please don't misunderstand me through the government program. Please don't, just an example for your learning. It always promoted for men. So masculinity, they promoted masculinity. Or any other brand you take, they were always consistent. They didn't change the message. And that is what we call in marketing communication, that you objectivize and you stay with those objectives. A company which is launching a new product today may have an objective to reach out to much larger audience, create awareness about the new product which they have launched in the market. It could be a new television, it could be a new car, it could be a new shampoo, it could be a new scheme for your mobile phone or anything. And all the ads which you see on television. So each of these campaigns, they have an objective. And that is the first thing I would like you to appreciate, that in marketing communication, you should think in terms of objectivizing because marketing communication actually is a collection of all elements in the organization marketing mix that facilitate exchange by establishing shared meaning with the organization customers. And in fact, these are the roles which we see in marketing communication. Communication might end with 1 and 2, inform and educate. But marketing communication goes beyond, and that is to persuade people. It is persuasive. Family planning program. In fact, there is a report of United Nations which says that the developing countries have to develop newer spacing methods. Developing countries cannot reach their family planning targets because the spacing methods are very limited. And therefore, if you look at, if you have to persuade people, persuasion has to be, in totality. And in fact, a more research when it was carried out, why people are going for more children is that they have a doubt that every single child coming to the family may not survive. So to that extent, the government has to ensure primary health. So you can see the synergy between different social programs, and these social programs particularly, they must synergize. Now, if you talk about the survival chance, that 100% survival chance to every child coming to a family, then for that there has to be the right marriage age. If there is a child marriage, if there is a child mother, the fetus mortality, infant mortality might be higher. Then similarly, the malnutrition or the knowledge about balanced diet, the knowledge about immunization, the knowledge about home management of diarrhea. Large percentage of children, they die because of dehydration, because if they get diarrhea, they get dehydrated. So home management of diarrhea became a very important program of the government, and the ORS, promoting ORS, became one of those programs of the government. So I'm just looking at and giving you examples so that you start understanding that in the Indian context, and as far as the social programs are concerned, the relevance of marketing communication even for the social programs. And you need to have an integrated approach. It cannot be just an advertising that you put paint a wall and on that you write something and tomorrow somebody comes and pastes a poster there. That cannot work. And that is where I call Anganwadis, which have started. In fact, they are educating people. And these primary health workers who have come in, social workers are now, NGOs are doing a good job on various social issues and so on. So coming back to the point from where I have started giving you so many examples, is that the marketing communication relates to identifying the issues and bringing about behavioral modification. How to bring about behavioral modification? How to persuade people to change their behavior? It's a behavioral modification that the parents must realize that the child at the age of 18 to 20, only then they become marriageable and not under that. So that's a behavioral modification. Spacing between children is again, it's a behavioral modification. That you don't go for a child every now and then, but you space between the children. Let the mother be ready for the second child. Only then you go for the next child. And this is where I call that persuasion is extremely important. And the fourth level is remind and motivate. Motivate people. And finally, we look at maintain relationships. They understand. In fact, the greatest problem with the family planning program has been that the people who, particularly the men who underwent vasectomy, they were not coming in open, in public, to say that, look, they have contributed to the national cause. They are really national heroes who, if they have undergone vasectomy. But they were shying away from telling others that I have undergone vasectomy. And the social stigma, which was from a manhood to becoming a non-something. So this is where I call the relationships, the maintained relationship. There should be a pride in, one should take pride in saying that, look, I did it and I contribute to the national cause. I put a full stop by putting one, having one child or two children, and I have undergone vasectomy. And this is where, you know, the marketing communication comes in. In fact, if I translate and use the local, that you call the person Namarth. Now, this is a stigma. This is where the stigma comes in. And I call, therefore, I find that there's a phenomenal role integrated marketing communication has for our social program. So I've taken, in the introductory part, I've taken about 20 minutes of your time to set the ball rolling, to make you understand that how important it is, this understanding on integrated marketing communication. So let us move from that. And
before we move, yes, ahead, sir, we'd like to ask a question. What is the difference between brand communication or say marketing communication and health communication?
Because you just identify the lacuna in the health advertisement what we have been seeing for many years. So what is the basic distinction one should have?
Let me finish the part, and towards the end I will take this question. Okay. Because otherwise I will only be talking about the health communication. Okay. and not on the rest. Okay. I picked up an example. Because I'm in an environment where I should not be talking too much of soaps and detergents and shampoos and so on. I thought I'll pick up an example and make my point relevant in a wider perspective, and then come to an understanding of brand communication. In fact, the next slide which you see, it talks about why promote. In marketing, people say, if you have a good product, it will sell. The fact is, large number of good products have failed in the market, and the fact is that large number of substandard products are also doing very well in the market. So what is the what is the reason? And this slide tells you that why you need to promote. This is a product choice. Every customer has a choice of products. If I want to buy a detergent, I have a choice. I can buy a detergent which costs me less. It may have low quality, but I am happy with it. I belong to a working class. My salary is very, very limited. My priority is food for the family. 60% of my income goes into the food and food-related expenditure. I don't have the money to get into superior detergents, which might be good for clothes, good for hand, and so on. So I just want to buy a detergent which is functional. Kapde dhulne chahiye saaf. So it works. And therefore you have a whole lot of detergents available in the market, which comes from the small scale sector. And they are doing very well. So there is a need for you to promote. The fact is that the looking at the detergent market, the multinational brands are not having the market share, bigger market share. The local brands or the lesser known brands, they have a major market share. Because of the very fact, the Indian society is like that. The Indian society is a large middle class. And the large middle class cannot afford to spend money on non-food items. Today, the way the food prices have gone up, the way fruits and vegetable prices have gone up, the way the edible oil prices have gone up, the milk prices have gone up, everybody in the middle class and lower middle class, they are feeling the pinch. And their expenditure has gone up. Kyunki khana to khana hai na. So that will have the priority. And this is where I call, there is a huge product choice people have. And that is why you need to promote, so relate your product to the customers. The second is physical and emotional distance. You need to relate the brand to a person. I asked this question to some students in the class, which brand of shaving cream do you use? There might be 20 brands in the market, but I got 3 or 4 names. What about the remaining? The remaining brands, they don't see that they are meant for them. These brands are not doing very well in the market. They have to work out a communication campaign to establish themselves in the marketplace. And this is where I call, there is a physical and emotional distance. I like something, I dislike something. So my dislike has to be converted into like. That can only be done through marketing communication. There is intense competition. That is another thing. How do you stand out of the crowd? I mean, if you go to any city, any market, in your own city, if there is a shopping area which you think is the best shopping area, you just count the number of hoardings which are there. If there is a TV program which is a popular program, you count the number of advertisements which are there. I remember that there was a time I was observing, and I found that if there is a television program for about half an hour, the actual program duration is about 22 minutes. 8 minutes are only advertisements. Each advertisement is only for 20 seconds to 30 seconds in general. Which means in half an hour, I am seeing so many advertisements. So that is where I am saying that there is a clutter. Take newspapers, take magazines. If you are traveling between one city to the other city, by train, by bus, by road, you come across so many hoardings. That is the real clutter I talk about. In Delhi, there is a place called South Extension Market. The South Extension Market has two parts, part one, part two. Half is on the left side of the road and the other remaining half is on the other right side of the road. It might be just less than one square kilometer area. But in that less than one square kilometer area, you will find more than 500 hoardings. This is the clutter we are talking about. How do you stand out in such a clutter? That is the task marketing communication has. So there is something called intense competition, and you have a challenge to stand out of the crowd. The third is a basic physiological need satisfaction to desires. Each one of us, we have a desire. We call that needs are common, but the desires are, or wants are, socio-culturally oriented. Each one of us feel hungry around 1 o'clock. What a South Indian prefer to eat is very different from what a Bengali gentleman would like to eat, or a North Indian would prefer to eat. And this is what I call, what the needs are common. Physiological need is common, but you desire, your wants are different. And that is what the marketing communication can do, that they can fit the market offers into the mold of desires. The third is high cost of promotion. Any promotion which you do, it costs you money. You cannot afford to spend money. You cannot afford to waste money, if I use this expression. And therefore, you have to promote and promote wisely. To remain competitive during periods of low demand. Every product has seasonality. It depends. Seasonality can be on a scale of 1 year, 365 days. For example, a hill resort, a hotel, or a lodge in Mussoorie or in Nainital or in Shimla or in Dalhousie will have a season. That season, out of the 365 days, 12 months, there is a season when people go. It could be holiday season. It could be summer time. What about the rest? What they do during rest of the year? If for 6 months there is no wedding season, they don't get traffic. So how do they survive? So similarly, there could be seasonality on a scale of a month. Understand the seasonality pattern for your market offers. It could be 365 days, it could be 30 days. Seasonality can be on a scale of 30 days. That when you go and buy, most people buy household supplies, ghar ka ration mahine ke pehle hafte mein kharidte hai. So there is a seasonality for first week out of the 4 weeks of a month. It could be there is a seasonality in terms of week. When people go and see movies in a cinema house, it could be Saturday, Sunday. When people go and eat in a restaurant, maybe Saturday, Sunday. When people get the food delivered in the house, maybe on Monday to Friday. So it could be a seasonality on a scale of a week, that is 7 days. It could be seasonality on a day, 24 hours. Like, when do you read newspaper? You read newspaper during 6 and 6:30, that's it. So that is a seasonality. When you watch television between 8:30 and 9:30. So that's a seasonality. Do you watch television in the morning? No. Do you read newspaper in the evening? No. So you have to understand seasonality patterns for your market offers. And in that seasonality, you have to understand that how can I do my business? That is one thing which the promotion will help you to understand. And finally, you need to look at how do I maintain my market share. If you have a particular market share, how do you maintain it? Otherwise, your customers can go to your competitors. And that is where even promotions can help you to retain your existing customers. For example, it could be my wife. She may buy a detergent than the one which she has bought last time. So how do you maintain market share? By telling women like my wife, and there are many women like that if you buy 5 kg of detergent, you get a bucket free. So, rather than buying 1 kg detergent every month, because of the bucket she has bought 5 kgs, and for 5 months she will be using your detergent. This is how you built market share, by loading more stocks on people. So promotions help you, sales promotions help you by loading more stocks. Ek ke saath ek free, buy 4 get 1 free. All these schemes help you to maintain your market share. Because of that additional offer, people buy 4. And these are the basic things one has to remember, that these are the factors, these 5, 6, 7 factors which I have shown and discussed with you. They help, they are absolutely necessary to understand to when you are thinking of, you know, why promote. The next point I want to emphasize is that there are 6 M's of marketing communication. These 6 M's are necessary. These are essentials. Only then you can develop a good marketing communication program. Don't neglect these 6 M's. The first is merchandise. Understand the market offer in an enormous detail. Understand, because that is the first concept in selling. You must understand what you are selling. If you don't know what you are selling, you can't sell. It is as simple as that. understand what you are selling. That is why in large number of companies, particularly in the pharma companies, they pick up salespeople with B pharma background. They don't pick up plain graduates. A company which is selling more of the electrical gadgets like Crompton Greaves, Siemens and so on, they pick up electrical engineers or electrical diploma holders. Why? Because they understand the technical dimensions of the product. And that is the first thing, that understand the merchandise. What are the important benefits of the products or services to be sold? Understand the merchandise. For example, if you see the advertisement of, say, Dove toilet soap, it says 125% moisturizer or 1/3 moisturizer. If there is moisturizer in the toilet soap, it will not leave your skin dry. So that communication has come after understanding the market offer. Similarly, there could be many other examples. And that is how one look at. The second factor which you have to understand is the understanding of the market. Who are the people to be reached? And amongst those people, it could be the buyer, it could be the user, it could be the influencer. It may not always be the buyer. It could be influencer. Medicines. Medicines to mareej khareedta hai na. If I am sick, I will buy medicines. How I will buy medicines? I'll go to the doctor. Doctor will prescribe the medicine. Doctor is the influencer. Then I go to the market. And the shopkeeper says, ye to aa nahi raha aajkal. This is not available in the market. I try the second shop, third shop. Finally, I go back to the doctor and say, sir, this medicine is not available. Then he changes the medicine. If the shopkeeper says, sir, this is not coming in the market these days, this is the medicine which is available. Should I give you this? You say, no, I'll check with the doctor. So influencer is the medical doctor. So many a times, the buyer may not be the target audience. It could be the influencer who could be the target audience. And today, companies are looking at children as a target audience because they are the users. So the users are also targeted in your marketing communication. And that is the second point I want to emphasize. That decide who are the people whom you want to reach, whether you would like to reach to the buyers, whether you would like to reach to the users or to the influencers. The third is motives. Why people buy? Motives vary. My son buy the same jeans or sports shoes. I also buy the same brand of jeans or sports shoes. The motive for which my son is buying a sports shoe is that it is a part of his dress code. He will wear those shoes throughout the day, Monday through Sunday. What he is seeking is, his motive is, it should be the latest design, it should be the latest color, it should be somebody, some hero must have been wearing in some movie. If the red shoe is in the market, he will buy the red shoe. If the lemon shoe is in the market, he will buy the lemon color shoe, and so on. So his motives are very different. When I am buying a shoe, same sport company's sports shoe, what I am seeking is comfort. So my motive is very different than my son's motive. Though we may be buying it the same, might be buying the same brand. And this is what I call, what would these people buy or fail to buy? Why these people buy and or they fail to buy? What are the motives behind them to buy or not to buy? Understand those motives and address those motives through your marketing communication. That is another point. The fourth element which one has to keep into consideration is message. Structure the message. Message cannot be purely, just words. Message can always be in the forms of objects. We have seen and we have heard in the news that different objects, they convey meaning. Even in Hindi, we have a saying, ek muhavra hai, chudiyan pehen lo. Now, that's object, a man wearing bangles. Yaar, tum to chudiyan pehen ke baithe ho. Now, that's an expression, object. When we were in college, if we were frustrated with the principal, we were sending bangles to our principal in a box. That was good enough to convey. If my friend is in hospital, I send a bunch of flowers of his favorite color. That convey my concern to my friend. So objects convey a lot. Diwali is just over. And we have seen how many crores worth of gifts people distributed. It's a huge industry. Gifting is a huge industry. People just give gifts. And Diwali gifting has undergone so much of a change. I remember as a child, Diwali gift meant in those times a basket. And in that basket, some kheel patasha, some crackers, some sweets, and some candles or diyas. Now, from there, it has gone to, you know, what kind of gifts we have seen 3 days ago or 4 days ago. So this is one thing we call the message. Message need not to be always words. It could be a visual, it could be an object, but that has to be very carefully crafted. What are the key ideas? What could be the information, attitude to be conveyed, which can move the prospect closer to the ultimate aim, that is sales. So develop the message, structure the message appropriately. And then is the next point, which is the fifth, we call media. Media means that what kind of media options you have. Doordarshan still has a very popular program for the last 50 years, if I recall, as far as I can recall, 45 years at least. This program is still there, called Krishi Darshan. Large percentage of farmers, they see this program. Now this program gives audience, farmer audiences. If you want to advertise for Sardar Urea or Jindal Pipes or some monoblock pump or some tube well or some tractor, you advertise around that program and your message goes to the right people. Because Sardar Urea ad doesn't have any meaning for me who is staying in a city like Delhi. And that is where the media habits have to be studied. What media vehicle can reach that group of people? Understanding of the media is extremely important. And the media has to be understood under three heads. The first is understand media as a medium. Ek madhyam hai, us madhyam ki kuch simaye hai. There are certain limitations of each medium. For example, newspaper is a medium to which people identify, because that's a medium people buy by choice. I read a newspaper which I prefer to read. It's my choice. Anything I read, I'm willing to take a bet on that. and someone is reading another paper in a vernacular language at a tea stall, he believes in what is written there. And newspaper is typically a medium which has, you know, that involvement is high, but it has a very limited shelf life. I read the newspaper in 20 minutes, half an hour maximum. Uske baad mere liye wo raddi hai. So that's the problem with the newspaper. Magazines have, if there is a magazine like Reader Digest, which has a shelf life of 1 month, the next issue comes only after a month. If I receive that magazine in my house, I don't even care to read it for a week or 10 days. The day on a particular Saturday or Sunday, when I am relatively free, only then I read it. So this is where there are publications has that characteristic. Radio people listen subconsciously. A barber is giving a haircut to someone and there is a radio playing in that shop. The barber attention is not on the song but or the advertisement. The barber attention is on the kind of haircut he is giving to the person. A housewife who is cooking food listening to the radio, her attention is on cooking, whether whatever she is cooking, whether onions have gone brown or not, she is concerned about that. Television is a medium which has a demonstration effect because it is live, it has movement, it has motion. But the television now has a problem in terms of proliferation. There are more than 1,000 channels we have. So the first is medium as a medium. These are the characteristics. The second is medium as a vehicle. That this medium reaches out to what type of audiences. What audience I want to reach out to and what media vehicle I should pick up. Large number of people in the city of Delhi, they go to the milk booth in the morning to fetch milk. 50% people in the household, 50% people from Delhi households, they visit the milk booth. They stand in the milk booth queue for 5 to 10 minutes. That's the time you can communicate with them. So that is the thing, that medium as a vehicle. Understand the medium as a vehicle. And the third is medium as a message. Each medium has its own credibility. A premium brand cannot have a low media vehicle. The media vehicle which has low perceptions, low impression, like inside the bus. Ek roadways ki bus ke andar jab aap chadte ho, to usme kis tarah ke products ki advertisement andar lagi hoti hai. Do you see premium brands being advertised as bus panels inside the bus? And that is where I call medium itself is the message. The media credibility is very important. So this is where I call, start understanding media, each media vehicle in terms of medium as a medium, medium as a vehicle, and medium as the message. And finally, the sixth issue is measurement. How do you measure the communication results? In terms of message delivered, in terms of number of audience reached, or in terms of response, how many people bought your product? So there are three different levels, or it could be more even, but it's important for you to decide how you measure your results. I mean, in India now, currently the elections are around the corner, political parties are campaigning, some of the parties have already started advertising on the television. How do you measure the effectiveness of these campaigns? That how many people saw the ad, but in spite of that, they didn't vote for that party? So you have to be very clear about unit of measurement. On what basis you will measure the effectiveness of your campaign? And beforehand, you should be very clear. Before you run it, you should be very clear about these are the parameters on which I will evaluate my campaign. So these are the six M's of marketing communication. And a combination of these three M's gives rise to this pyramid that on a basic offer, like ek sabun hai, ek pankha hai to pankha hai, ek TV hai to TV hai. So there is a microwave hai to microwave, a refrigerator, so it's a refrigerator. On the basic offer, you built a huge pyramid. And the pyramid has two dimensions. The first dimension is promotional inducements, and the other is these persuasive communication. A combination of these two will make your basic offer standing taller in the marketplace as against competitors. And that makes your market offer so different in the marketplace as against competition. And that is where I suggest give attention to these two dimensions called promotional inducements and persuasive communication. Many a times we found that persuasive communication has given good results. Honestly speaking, it's a wonderful jingle for a detergent powder which we all familiar with, Nirma. The jingle says, Pani mein rehkar kam gule, jada kapde dhoye, jada chale. When you say it 1,000 times, it settles in people's mind. And over the last so many years, this jingle has not changed. They may add some names, Rekha, Hema, Yeho, Sabki, Pasand Hai, and all that. But the main theme is that Pani mein rehkar kam gale, jada kapde doye, jada chale. So this is a communication, persuasive communication. They are telling people that it lasts longer. It gives you better wash and better number of clothes you can wash, larger number of clothes you can wash. So in my understanding, I really feel that you, on the basic offer, you build a tall pyramid. And the tall pyramid is that of promotional inducements and persuasive communication. That is how your product starts looking different at the marketplace. The basic offer, let me expand on these three parameters one by one, and then I will conclude or close as I have about 8-10 minutes. So the first is that the first mode is basic offer, which is companies, products or services in terms of product itself, its price, its discount, its credit, its warranty. So all that is the basic offer. And the second is, I called it persuasive communication. Persuasive communication can be advertising. It could be publicity, which is the media writing. It could be personal selling. Person comes to you and talk to you. It could be word of mouth, which you spread through your good, this thing. Then you look at non-verbal message in terms of packaging, brand name, and the direct mail or email and all that stuff. So these are all dimensions of persuasive communication. And finally, you give the promotional inducements. Promotional, in the meaning here is that they use consumer action. They trigger consumer action by offering extra substantive benefits. Extra and substantive. For example, free sample, or a trial use, or it could be discount, or money off, or premium, or contest. So these are put together are the different tools of integrated marketing communication which you use. For example, you use conferences, dealer conference, sales conference. In the pharmaceutical sector, these are very common. Even doctors are taken for conferences, and it is not purely holiday for the doctors. but also companies, they educate the medical doctors about the products which companies are launching in the market and their market share and they what kind of you know plans the company has. Similarly, in the FMCG sector or in the consumer durable sector, television or refrigerators and so on, dealer conferences are extremely important. Those industries where field sales force is extremely important, sales conferences are extremely important. So field sales force are the strongest, like insurance sector. Insurance sector actually grows only on the field sales people. A company, Eureka Forbes, had very strong field sales force for the water purifiers and the vacuum cleaners. Then you come out with a literature, sales literature, booklet, catalogs. Large number of companies, they have a market offer where they cannot take the product to the doorsteps of the people. If I have to buy in my office, if I have to buy a photocopying machine, somebody from Modizurax will come only with the catalog of the new machine which company has launched, with the photographs of the machines and the technical specifications of the machines. So that is where the literature which you create is very, very important. Then marketing PR. Now that's a new discipline which is now coming in. Marketing PR. You are doing public relations, but you have a marketing objective. For example, Femina as a magazine, it was, you know, as we look at the history of growth of media, mass media in India, what really happened was, as the television started growing during the decades of 90s, the print business, the publication started going down because every individual had only 24 hours. Out of those 24 hours, I need 8 hours to go and work and 6 to 8 hours to sleep. The remaining time I spend with the family, I need to travel between my home and my workplace, and a lot of time is gone in commuting between this. And then I need for my personal activities to get ready to take bath and all that stuff. So given the time, I only have 1 or 2 hours left. And in those 1 or 2 hours left, I was reading magazines at that time. But when the television started growing, I started reading, I started watching television. So that change has taken place. So what really happened, that publications started, you know, perishing from the market. There was a publication called Reader Digest. There was a publication, Illustrated Weekly. There was a publication called Saptahik Hindustan, Dharam Yug, and many others. So similarly, a publication, Femina. But then they started a contest, Miss Femina, Miss India, Femina, Miss India contest. And that contest gave tremendous, tremendous mileage to the brand. So contest and marketing, PR, advertising, sale promotions, packaging, direct marketing, sponsorships, all that are extremely important. And in fact, these are the elements which we use in the integrated marketing communication. Coming back to the question which the anchor asked me in the beginning, and I said that I'll take it towards the end. In fact, there is no great difference. Actually, you have to select out of the tools which I have shown. And in fact, integrated marketing communication means you look at out of these 10 different tools which are available, which one is extremely important. And each of these tools have to be used very strategically. It cannot be used in equal quantity for everything. So for social programs, it could be reaching out to the community is very important. Reaching out to the influencers is very important. For example, community leaders are extremely important. If you reach out to the community leaders, then you reach out to the community. For example, sarpanch or panches in a village, they are the opinion leaders. If they follow something, the others will also follow. But if the panchayat is opposing, I think the entire village will oppose it. And that is where, you know, reaching out to these people who are the influencer is extremely important. So friends, in today's, to summarize in the last couple of minutes, I would like to just say that integrated marketing communication cover a whole range of activities with a very clear purpose. And therefore, we use the word marketing communication, integrated marketing communication. On the contrary, communication is only where you look at re-understanding. But marketing communication aims at persuasion, influencing behavior, consumption, and acceptance of the product or the idea or a social program even. So with these words, I conclude and hand over to the anchor.
Okay, as you said that opinion leader or the community persons who have influence over the masses or the public, they have their role. But now when we look at the trajectory of development communication, now they are emphasizing more on the personal building of personal rapport with the public. They are not owning the two-step flow communication theory, a multi-step flow communication theory. Rather, they are believing that established direct-to-direct relationship, only then the development will come. So, but here, as you said, the persuading to adopt a product, use a product, and bringing development in the society, there are two things, because my question was related to this on the health communication and brand communication. So in that case, that like now let one should go or one should adopt the proper marketing communication or brand communication strategy.
Yeah, that's right, that you have to develop a strategy. In any case, in both the situations, you need to be very clear about what is your objective. And to reach those objectives, you develop a strategy. And for developing a strategy, these are the tools which one can use: conference, personal selling, literature, marketing, PR, contest, advertising, any of these tools.
Okay.
So that is how we look at.
Yeah, multiplicity of tools we can use for
reaching
to the
Absolutely.
Objectives.
That's right.
Okay. So the criticism is valid criticism, we can say. And one more question I'd like
The time is over, so we conclude, sir.
Yeah, we will conclude. We have 1-2 minutes. So the last thing I would like to say that, what is the precaution one should take while making this marketing communication?
We will discuss in the next issue.
So, well, friends, I hope today you have got what we want to communicate, and you must have learned a lot of things, because we try to explain through the examples. So I thank Professor Ravi Shankar for explaining the marketing communication and difficult topic to understand, but very lucidly and very simply with examples he made us to understand. So I thank him again, and I also thank all of you for watching the lecture. Thank you very much.